people who think you don't learn something from this show every day.
You're wrong.
You're absolutely wrong.
Gary and Shannon.
Weekdays at 10 a.m. on KFI.
Hey, if you're wasted, what are you doing going on television?
Or the radio for that matter.
Or the radio for that matter.
Gary and Shannon.
Weekdays at 10 a.m.
on KFI.
KFI.
KOSTHD2.
Los Angeles, Orange County. Live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
Motivated to kill. I'm Phil Hewlett from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. The man suspected of shooting one person to death and wounding five others at a Taiwanese church in Orange County reportedly told an acquaintance he might die in a big event, and his realtor says he had disdain for Taiwan before Sunday's shooting.
He doesn't like the Taiwanese current situation, trying to depart from China and trying to betray the Chinese, betray China politics and cultures.
The man apparently said that other people would die with him because the world is unfair to him. People whose houses were burned in the coastal fire are now suing Southern California Edison. They're blaming the company for starting the fire. 20 multi-million dollar mansions in Laguna Niguel were destroyed, 11 others damaged. The exact cause has not yet been determined, but SoCal Edison reported electrical circuit activity in the area at the time the flames were first spotted. New COVID cases are on the rise throughout much of the nation.
About 100,000 infections of cases a day. And we know that the number of infections is actually substantially higher than that.
White House COVID coordinator Ashish Jha blamed the increase on the new subvariants of the virus. A Senate vote is expected today on the roughly $40 billion package for Ukraine.
I expect the Senate will finish the critical task of approving another round of military, humanitarian, and economic aid.
Senate Majority Leader Chuck Schumer, the average cost for a gallon of regular gas in Los Angeles County is at a record high of $6.10. Orange County also has a record at $6.08. Friday's prices are expected to be a record as well. Southland weather from KFI. The sun might poke out a little bit this afternoon. Otherwise, a mostly cloudy Thursday for you with inland highs in the mid to upper 70s, mid-60s at the beaches, and a chance of drizzle late today and into Friday morning. Right now, it is 61 in Orange, Dana Point 58, Torrance is 61, and in Woodland Hills, it is currently 60 degrees. We lead local from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Phil Hewlett.
In Costa Mesa, we have a full freeway closure to keep an eye on the 405 northbound from the 73 to Harbor Boulevard. All lanes will be closed until 5, then in Whittier. On the 605 northbound before Valley Boulevard, there's a crash taking up the right lane right now, and traffic is bunching up as you approach. Then to Diamond Bar on the 57 southbound from the 60 to Pathfinder Road, there's a work zone taking up the two right lanes until 5. KFI in the sky helps get you there faster. I'm Vince Call.
Hey all, it's Dean Sharp. I want to tell you about the good folks at Aldic Home. In business for more than 60 years, Aldic is Southern California's premier Christmas and holiday shopping destination. But that's because Aldic is the unrivaled master of lifelike silk flowers, decorative trees, and all those one-of-a-kind accessories and finishing touches for your home. But did you also know that Aldic Home carries the finest custom outdoor furniture? More than 20 different lines and settings of summer classics. How good is summer classics? Come see for yourself. Aldic doesn't even want you to buy it. Just come down to Aldic and experience it. Take it for a test drive or a sit. Hang out. Bring the fam. And then go anywhere else and compare that experience. Aldic knows you'll be back for the highest grade of teak, aluminum, and woven resin furniture anywhere. You'll find Aldic on Sepulveda Boulevard in Van Nuys and on the web at aldichome.com. That's aldichome.com.
On the new true crime podcast, Betrayal, a woman chronicles her fairy tale romance gone horribly wrong. Her husband's secret life destroyed their marriage, shook their community, and ultimately sent him to prison.
Going through Spencer's emails, Snapchat, whatever I could get my hands on. Just a punch in the gut every single time.
Listen to Betrayal on the iHeartRadio app or wherever you get your podcasts. Brought to you by DuckDuckGo. Protect your privacy online for free with DuckDuckGo.
Another nice sunny day here in Southern California. The perfect time to think about going solar and saving some cash.
You might not think of going solar when it's still cool outside, but those hot summer days are coming. You're going to get the best deals right now at Solar Max Technology.
Just think, no more worrying. How much is this going to cost me to turn this AC on?
Listen, I love the low electricity bills, and the power company even pays me once a year now.
Now is definitely the time to be thinking solar, because Solar Max's spring Solar sale is on through May 31st.
Go solar for $49.93 a month, zero down, 0.99% APR. I mean, no one offers a complete solar panel system for that price.
You get a custom design system, a dedicated solar consultant,
and unmatched pricing and quality control, because solar max panels are designed, engineered, and assembled locally under one roof out there in Riverside.
Call Solar Max, get solar for $49.93 a month with zero down and a 0.99% APR.
Dial #250 on your cell and say the keyword SolarMax, #250 SolarMax, or go to solarmaxtech.com. Monthly payment available on approved credit, CSOB number 97248.
As the experts in transmissions for over 50 years, there's nothing at AMCO we haven't heard.
So when I hit the gas,
it's just a belt.
And nothing we can't fix.
It's going, what's that?
From transmissions to brakes and everything in between. No credit, finance your repair at AMCO. Exclusions apply, may not be combined with any other offer. Limited time offer, participating centers only. People who know go to AMCO. AAMCO.
This is Jacob Amrani. If you've been in an accident, call 844-24-JACOB.
We're going to be fine.
That doesn't sound like you're going to be fine.
We're going to be fine.
The Tim Conway Jr. Show.
It sounds like it's our last words.
Weeknights at 6 on KFI.
KFI, AM 640. More stimulating talk.
To Coast. We've got two special guests for you tonight. For the first half, Jay Rasley joins us. I'll tell you all about Jay in a moment, but they've got a couple TV shows out. Ghost Adventures, which has been around since 2008 on the Travel Channel with new episodes on the Discovery Plus, and a brand new program that is debuting on Discovery Plus as well called House Calls. So we'll be back with Jay in a moment, and later on Billy Tolley joins us on Coast to Coast. Both join us for phone calls next hour on Coast to Coast AM. Let's talk about our friend Dr. Squatch changing your shower game and the way you feel and the way you're refreshed and everything else. It's absolutely incredible. Dr. Squatch is transparent on their ingredients and production as well, offering the finest ingredients that Mother Nature has to offer. And all the products are at least 98% natural in origin, and you can recognize and pronounce everything you see on the packaging. They've even got a super convenient subscription plan available with extra savings and free shipping, so you just never run out when you need it most. Just simply sign up, choose your goods and scents, and shows right up at your door. Dr. Squatch has a 100% satisfaction guarantee as well. They're fantastic. Shop at drsquatch.com, where new customers will receive 20% off $20 or more you spend. Enter promo code COAST. That's drsquatch.com. Promo code COAST. Let me spell it for you. Dr. D-R, that's how they spell it, D-R-S-Q-U-A-T-C-H. Just run those together. DrSquatch.com, promo code COAST. Well, it's finally happened. The Fed is realizing the dire straits our economy is in due to our loose monetary policy. You can't just spend trillions every year with no repercussions. Now to play catch-up, the Fed has been raising rates and plans to 7 times this year. You're already starting to see those ripple effects in the housing market. as people's buying power diminishes. Have you considered what could happen in the stock market if our economy stalls out? Why not take some of your profits from the stock market now and solidify them with gold from Birch Gold? Throughout history, gold has maintained its value better than any other investment in the world. Text COAST to 989898 for a free, zero-obligation info kit on holding gold in a tax-sheltered retirement account. Join the thousands of happy Birch customers with countless five-star reviews, an A-plus rating with the Better Business Bureau. I trust the professionals at Birch Gold. Text COAST to 989898 and secure the gains while you can. And welcome back to Coast, George Norrie with you. Jay Wazley started his filmmaking career in Philadelphia as a director of photography and audio engineering. Since 2002, he has worked on dozens of feature films, documentaries, television shows, commercials as well, music videos. He joined Ghost Adventures in Season 4 as the Paranormal Investigation Team's sound mixer and has since evolved into one of the show's audiovisual technicians and cinematographers. Throughout the series, he travels with the team to domestic and international locations rumored to be haunted in search of evidence, providing evidence for the supernatural. Jay, welcome to the program. Good to have you here.
Yeah, thanks for having me. Happy to be here.
And this is a great thing. How did this all start for you?
So for me, I mean, from the show start, they actually reached out to me. It was about 12 years ago, 2010. I was doing a lot of camera work and sound work and different TV shows, movies, projects, things like that. And Ghost Adventures started, there were a couple years in, and they originally would hire a local sound guy wherever they would go, but sometimes when you're investigating paranormal activity, you're in kind of in the middle of nowhere sometimes, and they got to a point where they wanted to bring on a full-time sound guy, and I was sent out, you know, just kind of brought on as the sound guy to during the first half of the show, when we do a lot of research and interviews, things like that. I would come out, I would fly out, I'd record all the sound for that, and then fly out before the investigation. But being such a small knit group, we don't have big crew or anything like that. We do a lot of the filming everything ourselves. We became good friends being on the road, and I started throwing ideas out to Zach and the guys saying, oh, you can try to do this or do this type of experiment, or you can analyze something like this. And then Zach was like, that sounds great, do that, why don't you do that? And he started bringing me on a little bit more and a little bit more, and it just kind of evolved from there and became stopped doing sound, became a cinematographer on the show, and then became much more involved in front of the camera as well as a audiovisual technician and investigator.
Now, prior to them bringing you in, were you a believer in the paranormal side?
Yeah, absolutely. Since I was a kid, actually, I've had paranormal experiences. I kind of always talk about, you know, kind of joke, but it's true. Like, I feel the fact that I got this show and got this job doing this and been able to do this for so long, like there's some kind of weird greater meaning behind it, and like my life kind of came full circle. As a kid, I was into the paranormal. I played with Ouija boards, have crazy Ouija board experiences, you know, in teenage years. I had a friend actually get possessed once and try to stab me in the throat during a Ouija board session.
Oh my god.
It was crazy. Like, so I was a believer. There was definitely much more. And I was really into a lot into studying like physics and the science behind things, as well as different beliefs that, different religious beliefs, different ways of thinking. And I was fascinated by it. So I was always studying it and kind of building this knowledge and this research of all these different beliefs and, you know, theories basically.
As an audio engineer, Jay, I bet you must have some incredible audio that you've recorded.
Oh, yeah, there's things, and, you know, even to this day, when we do an investigation, I still approach it skeptically. You know, we don't want to just go in there and automatically assume everything is paranormal. And there's things that still, to this day, after doing it for so long, that honestly still blow my mind. I'll hear voices, we'll get audio recordings that just, there's no explanation for it.
Do you sometimes search around to make sure nobody's trying to pull your leg?
Yeah, I mean, definitely it's something to consider, but we have it. What's great about our show is when we do the investigation, it's only us in there. With Ghost Adventures, it's just the four of us. We film the cameras ourselves. We don't even have a sound guy. It's literally just whoever you see on camera are the only ones there. So we have the whole place. We call it a lockdown because it's locked down. It's just us in there. It's fully controlled.
How do you get your locations, Jay? Do people contact the program and say, I think my house or my place is haunted? How does it happen?
Yeah, I mean, a lot of the stuff, we have some researchers that work for us, but also a lot of the fan base through social media. We get messages every day from people all over the place saying, you should come check out our town, or the town I grew up in, there was this one spot. We're always hearing cool new places. With House Calls, it's our new series that we're doing, Ghost Adventures House Calls. With that series, it actually started Zach from the show put out a tweet asking families if they were having any difficulty with paranormal activity at their homes to submit a video kind of letting us know what was going on, and it was incredible. The turnout was amazing, and it kind of opened my mind, which I was aware of it, but it really opened my mind to how many people out there are actually having paranormal activity in their homes. And I think a lot of these people, and even, you know, I'm so thankful for shows like yours and shows like ours and all the other, you know, there's a dialogue now with this, where so many years ago, people didn't really talk about it. So a lot of people kind of had these experiences, but they had to hold it in. They couldn't deal with it. They couldn't get through it. So it was amazing to see how many people opened up to us and invited us into their homes for these stories. And we went through them. We picked out, unfortunately, we can't help everybody. There's just too many. And we kind of picked out some families that we felt were really in crisis, that really needed our help. We focus on those. And in the new series, we go out and we focus just on individual people's homes and trying to help them document what's going on so they know they're not crazy, so they know that they can actually rest their mind that, yes, these things are happening. And then we try to provide them with help, what they can do to cleanse the house before we leave. We'll actually do a cleansing as well, and then give them further analysis about what we captured and what was going on.
I was going to say, is there a difference between House Calls and Ghost Adventures? And I guess there's a big difference, isn't there?
In Ghost Adventures, we have done private homes before. This one is just private homes, and we dig a little deeper, I think. It feels more personal, it's much more emotional. And I feel like there's a little bit more on the line, because we're going to these people with the direct goal to help them, you know, and we interview these people, we talk to them and hear their stories, and it's heartbreaking a lot of the time. You know, these are families that are getting torn apart by paranormal activity. We have places, you know, there was a place in Kansas we did where in the early 1900s, the whole town was destroyed by a tornado, and there's this house, and the kids are afraid to go in a certain room of the house. Like, no one wants to go there. Nobody should live like that. So I feel with House Calls, there was a little bit more on the table that we wanted to be able to help these people and, you know, not let them down.
Well, with Jay Wasley, in a moment, Billy Tully will be joining us to talk about his portion. He's one of Jay's partners on these programs. How long are you in these houses, Jay?
It varies. With House Calls, they're kind of quicker investigations. We wanted to cover as much as we can, so we kind of get in it, and there's no time wasted. From the moment we ring the doorbell and they let us in, we're filming and investigating. We have equipment going to document anything that happens, as well as interviewing the families while we do it to kind of hear their stories. And having them there, you know, we can also see what the energies are like and how things react when they're in the house. And then they'll leave, and then we spend the rest of the night just by ourselves investigating their home. So House Calls is a quick one. Regular Ghost Adventures, we take a little bit longer. We do more interviews, more stylized type shots, things like that, and it goes over the course of a few days.
Would you say that most spirits that you may have encountered are friendly as opposed to demonic and evil?
Honestly, I wish I could.
Oh.
I think, I mean, and I'm not saying that there's not, I don't know if there's more out there. I think we tend to get drawn more to the more demonic, more evil cases. And especially with house calls, those are the cases where people seem to need more help. You know, if it's a friendly ghost kind of, you know, haunting this house, the family's not as much in need of our assistance than if there's something really dark, demonic, and they're being scratched and things are flying around the house and such. So we tend to focus a little more on the darker investigations.
What would you say, Jay, in your career as a paranormal investigator, was the strangest thing you've encountered?
Oh, man, there's been a lot. I think over 12 years, and I think we're up to almost 300 episodes or maybe even more now.
That's amazing.
I mean, there's so many for different reasons. I think one personally for me, we were investigating an old saloon in Prescott, Arizona, and it was an old saloon, Wild West, and I love those old Wild West towns. There's so much energy. And we were investigating, and the people working there were afraid to go in the basement because there was an opening to the crawl space, and everyone kept saying, that crawl space, that's where the evil entity resides, that's where it stays, that's where it comes out of. So during the investigation, I got sent into the crawl space by myself, and it's a crawl space. So, I mean, anyone that's been down in a crawl space, it's pretty tight, and I'm 6'2", I'm a big guy. I'm on my belly crawling through there with a camera in hand, being like, all right, what's going on in here? And at first, nothing was happening. It was kind of quiet, honestly. And then I got agitated. I started getting annoyed. I was like, all right, you know, if you're this big bully spirit, you're this evil entity, and you're tormenting these people, then do something. You know, I've never been a fan of bullies. You know, I think that's kind of how I look at it, you know. And you know, if we're dealing with a friendly ghost, I'll be friendly. But if we're dealing with something that's tormenting people, we're going to step it up and kind of, you know, fight back a little bit, if you will. And I started trying to call it out, trying to see if I can get any kind of reaction. And I got sick to my stomach.
Oh,
and then I felt something grab my foot. I kick. There's nothing there. I have the camera in front of me, and I'm on my belly. Try to paint the picture for you guys. I'm on my belly. The camera's on my hand is like above my head, shooting back towards me. And something grabs my foot and drags me backwards. I drop the camera. I get dragged backwards, probably a good 3 or 4 feet away from the camera. And you see this all on camera, and you can clearly see that there's nothing behind me. And it absolutely terrified me. And the problem is, I'm in a crawl space, so I can't just jump up and run away. I can't just run outside and get some air and bring it together. I'm stuck in this little crawl space, kicking, and dust is flying everywhere.
Jeez.
And, you know, I to this day, it still gives me chills because I don't know what that was. You know, I wish I could come up with a rational explanation for what that could have been. It would help me sleep better at night at times. But there isn't one. I just can't. That experience definitely still, you know, it shook me up a lot.
How do you, as the group of four, decide what place to go to once you get the information? Let's say you've got 20 applications. How do you pick the ones?
I mean, I think it's, you know, with house calls, I think it was a sense of urgency. We were fortunate enough to get a lot of video submissions so we could see the families, we could see the people, we can, you know, and when you see somebody, you can actually see their body language, how they react, their emotions.
And they're serious. They're not trying to pull the wool over you, are they?
Exactly, yeah. And, you know, we watch for that stuff because, you know, out of hundreds and hundreds of submissions, who knows, there might be people out there that are trying, but we would go through them and, you know, kind of find the ones that are like, all right, you can actually, you watch, anyone that watches these submission videos, which we show them actually in the episodes, to kind of set up what the original all was about. You feel it. You feel that energy. You feel that pain from these families. And, you know, you automatically, I feel like we get this attachment. We're like, all right, we're part of this family now. We need to help them. And, you know, those are the ones we go for.
Well, good for you. And You were saying that earlier in your life you played with the Ouija board. I don't recommend that. No. If you were to do it all over again, would you play with it? Or do you still do that?
I mean, I still have done it. I don't recommend other people to do it. I feel like at this point in my life, and I guess in my career as well, it's kind of like we've gone so deep with it. I'm kind of the guy on the team, too, that we'll try different rituals, things like that, and I'll be the one to lead it just to experiment. I want to experiment as much as possible. And if that is with a Ouija board, if it's with rituals, sure. If it's with scientific experiment, if it's with sound waves and frequencies and all kinds of stuff, I want to try it. I want to try it all just to be able to figure out more and more about what's going on and what happens after we die and try to document the best evidence.
Have you gotten some answers for yourself, Jay, that have solved some of those questions?
I've definitely gotten answers. But at the same time, I think it's like many things, the more answers you get, the more questions you have. And doing it for so long, you get to a point where you're like, all right, I've probably seen everything by this point. I've heard it all. What else could there be? And we'll go on an investigation and something happens that still just blows my mind. And, you know, it's one of those things, you know, researching in this field, you get to points where you're like, okay, I think I get it. I think I finally understand what's going on here. And then something else happens that just throws a whole crazy variable in that you never thought of and just blows your mind. And now you're back like, wow, like what is, we got to keep going. Let's try something else. Let's figure this out. So, I mean, in some ways I feel there's moments that I get answers, but then, you know, I still always want more. I still want that definitive kind of answer.
Knowing what you know, what do you think of people who ridicule people who believe in the paranormal?
Yeah, I mean, I don't think it's right to ridicule anybody for whatever they want to believe in or what they experience. I understand people being skeptical. I get it. You know, it makes sense in some, you know, people want to have that logical, safe mindset. I get it. You know, comfortable, you know, it gets weird and scary to think about this kind of stuff. And I don't necessarily blame people for being that way. And I think it honestly, sometimes it takes your own personal experience, something that you might go through to accept it, you know, and if that's what it takes for you to accept that there is much more to it, then that's how it is. But I know without a doubt, you know, from my experiences, that there's much more to this world, to this reality that we know of, and that there's much more that goes on after death than just being rotting in a box. Yeah. You know?
When you've come across house calls, have you come across a family that was just so distraught over the hauntings that have been occurring at their houses? They're emotional, they're crying, they're all upset.
Yeah, we've had a few that have been very emotional, crying, you know, families. We had I think it's our premiere episode, we had a young married couple that have a new baby too, and they feel that there was something attached to the husband even since he was a childhood, and they're living in his childhood home, and they think this thing's been there, and talking to them, seeing their pain and struggle, like it's literally tearing them apart. And personally, I've had experiences with that. I think all of us on the show, you know, that's the thing I always try to tell people too. This isn't just a show. It isn't just a job for us. This is our lives. We bring a lot of this stuff home. I've had relationship problems. I was married, and long story short, my ex was working with us on the show, and she was around it, and basically got overtaken by energies and spirits, and she quit the show, and it ultimately
destroyed the marriage, huh?
Yeah, we couldn't come back. Like, it kind of got to her so bad where it tore us apart. And, you know, thankfully, once we did split and everything was okay and she went on and kind of just got away from the paranormal, she got better. And I'm happy to report that.
Jay, just stay with us. We're going to come back and get your partner on, Billy Tully, and talk with him for about a half hour or so. And then both of you will join us in the last hour of the program tonight to take phone calls next on Coast to Coast AM.
Do you have a photo that you think would interest the Coast to Coast audience? We're always on the hunt for unique and unusual images for our photo gallery. To submit your image, simply go to coasttocoastam.com and mouse over the media button on the upper navigation bar, and you'll see the submission option.
From the KFI 24-hour newsroom. People whose houses were burned in the coastal fire are now suing SoCal Edison, blaming the company for starting the fire. 20 multi-million dollar homes in Laguna Niguel were destroyed, 11 others damaged. The exact cause has not yet been determined, but SoCal Edison reported electrical circuit activity in the area at the time the flames were first spotted. The man charged with committing a deadly shooting at a Taiwanese church in Orange County mailed a 7-volume diary to a Chinese-language newspaper in L.A. The World Journal has given the diary to the police and will not be publishing it. The average cost for a gallon of regular gas in L.A. County is a record $6.10. Orange County, also a record, $6.08. Southland weather from KFI. The sun might poke through Thursday afternoon, otherwise mostly cloudy today, with inland highs in the mid to upper 70s, mid-60s at the beaches. A chance of drizzle late and into Friday morning. Right now it's 60 in Anaheim, Ladera Ranch 56, Long Beach 61, and in Pasadena it's also 61 degrees. We lead local from the KFI 24-hour newsroom, Mike.
In Carson, on the 405 northbound at Carson Street, there's a crash to keep an eye on in the left shoulder of the off-ramp that is causing some minor delays. Then in Diamond Bar, on the 57 southbound from the 62 Pathfinder Road, there is a work zone closing the two right lanes until 5. Finally, in Costa Mesa, on the 405 northbound from the 73 to Harbor Boulevard, there is a full three-way closure until 5. KFI in the Sky helps get you there faster. I'm Vince Call.
On the podcast Not Lost, embark on a journey to all the destinations on your bucket list. From Mexico City to Montreal, as strangers become new friends, drinking, dancing, and eating their way through each episode.
What comes to mind when we think of Montreal? I definitely think of poutine,
of course.
I think of you guys.
They're everywhere. Listen to Not Lost on the iHeartRadio app or wherever you get your podcasts. Brought to you by DuckDuckGo. Protect your privacy online for free with DuckDuckGo.
As parents, we've done everything possible to protect our kids from COVID-19, from using hand sanitizers to masking up. But now we have the most important tool, vaccines. They help protect our children and the entire family. And it's okay to have questions. Ask your doctor about the COVID-19 vaccine for your child or visit vaccinateall58.com.